Yeah, for me, to keep on designing and to keep justifying keeping designing things, I do need to get something in return, of course. So a way to do it is like with donations, but it's also possible to just sell my products and just give me a percentage of that profit you made to me. It doesn't mean you have to do it with every part and then directly you have to pay me something. There's a lot of hassle. You can just say like in 1 month time or longer, say okay, I sold this, okay, this amount I'll give you as an donation for your work, for designing it. Then it's less trouble for you and for me, then I get just one bigger amount from you than that you have every time for small things. There's a lot of work for you, and so I can imagine that's not really nice. But to be like a dealer, you can just contact me and we can just talk something out. If you feel confident about your printing skills, you can just do that. It really doesn't mean that it is like you become like a shop and you need to do a lot of things, but you can keep yourself so busy as you or so quiet if you want. There's no pressure. But it's kind of nice to have, like for me, living in Europe, and there's something in America and he wants to have something for me. It's nice to have somebody in America print that and send it to him. It's a lot less shipping costs, it's closer by. In some cases, maybe the communication is a lot better if it is in a different speaking country. That person who's contacting me can speak English, but maybe other people in that country is not so good with English, then the communication goes better and things like that, and it saves some shipping cost, saving some shipping cost and shipping time, and send some of the donations to me directly, but you save some the shipping cost than paying a lot on shipping cost and say like, yeah, it's already getting way too expensive, I'm not that interested anymore, or yeah, now there's not much room left for some extra for you for designing this stuff and things like that. So that's why I kind of was playing around with that idea. I don't have a website right now, but I'm kind of looking into that to make kind of more official, like a website and things like that. So it could be, I got a few people who want to work with me already. And I want to make like kind of a dealer list, something like that. That you can see, okay, I can contact somebody directly in my country or closer by. I will probably do him. And you can say, you can also tell like what type of materials you will be printing. And then people can choose in that criteria as well, that they say that it must be patchy or it must be PLA, because then I can pick every color of the rainbow and he supports that. Then you got those type of decisions you can make as like a customer, somebody who wants to buy. And with Thingiverse, I also made a group where you can see like when some products maybe are updated. Some products sometimes are updated because there's some small error in or I make an improvement. So there's like a group in that, there's a topic in that group that will show all the updates. So you can see, oh, okay, I don't have to check that file directly on this Thingiverse site. If it's updated, can see it right there. And you can see like a dealer list. If you say like I'm a bit busy, but oh, there's another guy in like let's say the USA, and maybe he is something I can refer to, and maybe sometimes when he is busy because I've referred to him before, then he will think about me and refer to me. So you can kind of make friends in a way that if you're busy with a project, your printer, you don't have time, you can contact him and he will maybe do that the same to you. then his printer is busy or broken, things like that. But yeah, for now it's kind of small scale. It's not that the group, I think I'm the only member, to be honest. So maybe this is not the best idea, but I kind of throw it out there. Maybe some people say, yeah, I kind of like the idea of that group. And I'm just starting out with this also. I just have to see what kind of works, what not. And I've saved, of course, the contacts with people who do say, like, oh yeah, I live in Germany or somebody in Brazil. Things like that, then already get a little bit of a network, but we'll see how it will go over time. But that's kind of a model I kind of like, because I don't really want to be somebody with a lot of printers at home and print for like the entire globe, things like that, and be shipping and I mean, I could do that, but I'm not really feeling like I want to go that route. I just want to be a designer and things like that, and not invest a lot in making sure and then promote myself like crazy to keep it justifying all those printers and to keep them running and yeah, dealing with all the shipping and contacting and the pressure to be like really out there and have a big connection that people really know about my thing. And because now with the multiple people approach of it, decentralized way, it's like the guy in Germany has his own group he knows, and sometimes there are maybe some people who want to buy it, and I don't say it's like doesn't have to be much every year or things like that. There's no pressure in it at all. But of course the guy in Brazil knows his people there, and so you got a lot big spread audience that way. Then in comparison, if I would do it all alone, then I need to reach out to them, and I don't speak their language even. So this way then it's kind of spread out. Also spread out with the printers, because you know with the printer it doesn't scale at all. So it doesn't matter if it is 10 of the same products, it still takes that amount of time to print, and that I cannot change that. So it's better to have it spread out with different people, and I don't mind to print sometimes some few things for somebody, of course, but it's not really my focus. So that's why I kind of have this proposal of a way to do this, and that way it's because I really like designing things, but of course I do need to make some money as well. So there must be some way for me to earn a living on it, or not at least earn something from it. So it's for me okay to spend a lot of time on designing things, and now how less it is, I'm more, I really have to be hard on myself and just say, no, I must do other productive things, because it's just especially when it are things that I don't really need. Like, some people say, like, yeah, make the TPX magazine adapter. Yeah, I could do that, but for me, it's not interesting. If it would be interesting in the sense I get something in return of it, like money, then yeah, I would be definitely interested. But for me personally, I have no use for it. And you could also say, yeah, but all the different angle adapters. That's true, I did not have a need for that as well. But I kind of had like, I already made that magazine adapter, and it's not that much work to make a different angle. So yeah, why not? But really to make for the T15 and like the TPX, I'm really open to it to do it, but there must be some form of compensation for it. I cannot do it all for nothing, and and just like, oh yeah, you can download it and that's all. There must be something because it does take time and the printer have to run and the prototyping and the plastics that will go through it. It's not like my first design is like works every time. No, sometimes it takes a few prints to make it all really work, and I do get better at it. But still, it's not. It's really rare. I think I've had one time that it was like I designed it, I printed, and it worked. And I was like, oh wow, I'm really amazed. A lot of times, this is like 3 times to get there. And sometimes I'm lucky I can just tweak the small parts, then that's less plastic, less printing time, but still it takes time. And that's why I made this proposal. And I'm also planning to make a few videos about how I use my 3D designing program. By no means I'm really skilled at it, but that's really the point. Because a lot of people say like, I'm really amazed that you can design all these things. And in a way I'm too, because a year back I would say, no, I cannot do this. But I just start doing it and I just know like maybe 10% of the program. But with the 10% of the knowing the program, you can make basically all the things I've made until now. And it's quite a lot of few things. And every time when you do make something and it feels too time consuming and things like that, then it's really time to start looking up some videos and really start like, maybe, I don't know how it's called, but maybe there's a way to make this easier. And that's the way how you learn, and you make keep making it bigger and better, and your skills and starts growing and things like that. The thing for me, I think, is now about time I start to just check out, it must be not that hard, is how do I put in type on my design? I have really no idea, and before I had really not a strong desire to do. I was already happy that I got it, and I had something like, yeah, what should I put on there anyways? And I was not really, I do like to kind of put my brand on things, but at the same time, I did not really feel like it, that I really wanted to do that with my designs for the 3D printing stuff. But so that's the maybe thing, but I was planning to maybe make a few video series of it, and that way show you that it's quite easy, and then you will probably see like, okay, I can do those things just myself and be creator yourself and support the community that way of designing. And that's really it. That's what I wanted to talk about. And if you are interested in being a part of the sellers and things like that, just contact me or put a comment below, or contact me on Thingiverse. Doesn't matter, and we can probably arrange something. It's not that hard. There's no contracts in the sense you need to buy and sell thing. No. If you just sell one thing that you had, you just sell one thing that you had, it doesn't matter. Then you have earned something by selling that thing, and I guess you that's not really a big problem. That's just the extra money for you and something for me. So it should be like a situation like we are both happy. And if a few people will do that and just sell one thing in a year, it's still something I get in return for all the designing I do. So it's not the idea that it has to be like one big company thing. And if it gets there, then yeah, it gets there, but that's not really the ambition for now. I don't expect that to happen at all, so don't worry about like, if you can print, you can print. Because I have a lot of people that contact me back when I was contacting them about it. It's like, yeah, my printing skills is not that good. But well, it's not good. Always some imperfections in your prints. It's really hard to have that really that perfect level, at least in my opinion. At least I print with PETG, and that's not really... sometimes it'll leave some marks on it, so yeah, I will just remove it, and it's a functional, good print. And but yeah, it's up to you. Of course, be fair with yourself. If you're saying like, I'm really good at printing and think that, and it's just garbage and falls apart and you can break it easily, and then of course it would probably not so good to be in seller, because then people will get angry and really fast at you for what is this, what did I pay for this, this is a piece of garbage. But yeah, that's it, and see you guys next time.